When you think of American anime characters, you think of Bandit Cave. The bandana, the sunglasses, the alcoholism, and the gun are all integral to the American lifestyle, and make Keith one of the most memorable characters of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Franchise. Bandit Keith, or Keith Howard if you go by the manga, serves as one of the major antagonists of the Duelist Kingdom arc, being Joey's rival from the midway point into the semifinals where he is defeated. From there, two very different paths lay out before our flag banana-wearing protagonists. One full of failure, defeat, and possession. The other, death, also failure, revival, and possible redemption. Today we're going to lay out the rise, fall, and rise again of Bandit Keith. Keith's relevance begins with his relationship with Pegasus. During the final round of a championship in America, Keith dueled Pegasus, who used his Millennium Eye voodoo magic to learn what Keith's hand was, and chose a random child in the audience to take over the duel in his stead. Upon using the directions listed by Pegasus in a note, the boy, apparently his name is Sam, who the f*** is Sam, defeats Keith. Keith, like many other Yu-Gi-Oh! Players upon losing a duel, turned to hard drug addiction and gambling to cope with his loss. Eventually, he got the bright idea of sneaking onto the boats leaving for Duelist Kingdom to get his revenge on Pegasus for his defeat. He teams up with characters Bones and two other irrelevant cronies to obtain enough star chips to enter the castle. The main cast's first interaction with Bandit Keith is when Joey is kidnapped by Minion 1 and focused into dueling Bones. Honestly, Keith's role during this duel is pretty cool, serving to advise Bones' moves and strengthen his deck with Call of the Haunted, which in the anime lets his monsters revive endlessly and be powered up by Pumpkin, the King of Ghosts. Eventually, through an actual legitimate strategy, Joey manages to beat Bones, causing Keith, Bones, and Thing 1 and Thing 2 to trap the group in a cave. Keith then beats Bones in the Peanut Gallery to take their star chips and enter the castle. The next major appearance of Keith was during Yugi and Seto's rematch in front of the castle gates, providing commentary that shows he is actually rather impressed with Yugi's skills, but ultimately finds his surrendering to be insane, despite Kaiba threatening to yeet himself off the wall if he loses. Keith's big spotlight in this arc comes in the semifinals of the tournament, where he is set to duel against Joey Wheeler. Before the duel, Keith steals Joey's entry card, Glory of the King's Hand, which would inevitably lead to Joey's disqualification. However, Mai Valentine, who lost the previous round against Yugi, gives Joey the card so he can save his sister. Bandit Keith is shocked by this revelation, but proceeds to duel against Joey regardless. Here is where we are introduced to Bandit Keith's deck, which is primarily focused on machine monsters. Due to the absolutely convoluted rules of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist Kingdom arc, which is basically whatever I say goes, machine monsters are unaffected by, quote, non-physical attacks, so they are immune to spell cards and any other magical attacks that Joey's monsters may be able to use. Along with this already obscene advantage, Keith subtly cheats throughout the duel by pulling cards from his wristband. Honestly, this begs the question of what would have happened if Keith won. Would Pegasus have disqualified Keith anyways, or let him progress? Anyways, Joey mounts a comeback by reviving Red Eye's Black Metal Dragon, and attacks Slot Machine, defeating Bandit Keith. Keith immediately accuses Joey of cheating due to the card that Mai gave him, but Joey counters that Keith should be disqualified, which is kind of redundant considering he just lost, but whatever. Pegasus agrees with the latter statement, having his guard restrain him. Keith breaks free and holds Pegasus at gun/finger point, depending on what you watch, demanding that he receive the prize money. Pegasus hits a button on the floor at Mr. F***ing Burns and causes Keith to flail screaming into the ocean below. Bandit Keith was conveniently rescued by a nearby ship of rare hunters and uses a puppet by Merrick Ishtar in the Battle City arc. He dresses up as a fortune teller to trick Yugi and steals the Millennium Puzzle, attaching it to a dueling arena inside a nearby warehouse. Yugi eventually guesses Keith's identity by his use of machine monsters, completely ignoring the ever-present 5 o'clock shadow, which would have probably gave him away sooner. Despite this, Keith's upgraded deck, including Zera the fucking Mant, allows him to corner Yugi. Yami Bakura is actually the character to save Yugi in this instance, breaking Merrick's control over Keith. Keith, in a blind panic, breaks the puzzle in a bid to prevent what he thinks is causing the possession, and eventually causing the entire warehouse to be engulfed in flame. Keith is last seen escaping the area, running past Joey and Tristan. What exactly happens to Bandit Keith at this point is up to speculation. His soul appears during the Waking the Dragons arc in the Stone Wilderness. Keep in mind that this does not necessarily confirm his status one way or the other, as characters that are proven to be alive and dead in the anime both appear here, such as Paradox Brothers Weevil Underwood on one hand and Yami Merrick on the other. So frankly, who the hell knows? Ultimately, whether the rare hunters ended up killing Bandit Keith or his soul was taken by the Silver War of Kalkos, this is the last time we see Keith in the canon of the anime. Anyway, that is the rise and fall of Bandit Keith. If you like this series and want me to do more, leave a like and maybe subscribe. Keith, after recovering from his shock at Joey returning with the honor of the King's Right, begins the duel. Playing a machine-based strategy that nullifies magic cards and attacks, Keith initially put Joey on the defensive, However, Joey began slowly gaining footing throughout his duel through the use of trap effects, which Keith's monsters were vulnerable against. Pegasus, who was initially confused about Joey's progress against the former champion, used the Millennium Eye to read their minds. While Keith was too focused on revenge to strategize properly, Joey was hopeful that he could win. The disparity made Keith more liable to mistakes, which Joey capitalized on. Keith, cornered, asked Joey if he had ever risked his life, and described hell, where it doesn't matter who you have to kill as long as you save yourself. To Keith, winning the Duelist Kingdom, defeating Pegasus, and getting the prize is the only way out of this hell. Also keep in mind that, unlike the anime, the circumstances between Keith and Pegasus' duel was different, with $1 million were on the line, and Keith's loss also financially ruined him. This is markedly different than the anime where he just loses the tournament and immediately goes to alcoholism and gambling. Keith, like his anime counterpart, loses the duel to Joey's Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon. Distraught, Keith met Pegasus in the hallway at knife point, demanding the prize money. Pegasus admonishes Keith for cheating and states that he lost his duelist mind, which I take to mean that before his loss to Sam, he was a relatively fair player. So, like any reasonable man, Pegasus turns Keith's hand to a gun and forces him to play Russian roulette, eventually ending his life. However, while this will be the end for many men, Bandit Keith is not just any man. In chapter 16 of the manga series Yu-Gi-Oh! R, Bandit Keith makes his return to the story. Pegasus' unknown adopted son, long story, revived Keith with the power of the Wicked Avatar, which are shadows of the Egyptian gods with similar powers, long story. Yako used Keith's revival as a means to gain information about the death of Pegasus. Long story, but I have a video for that here. Dang. Keith lied to Yako and said that Yugi killed Pegasus. Keith genuinely thought this was true until being proven otherwise, but likely lied so he could stay in the mortal realm. Keith goes on to become a key antagonist in the series, serving as one of the Card Professors, a group of powerful duelists that are hired by Yako Tenma. Specifically, Keith's lies serve to exacerbate Yako's anger toward Yugi, which furthered the corruption that the Wicked Avatar had over him. After one of the professors loses against Gecko Tenma, Yako's brother who has defected to Yugi's side, Keith offers to take them directly to Yako. However, this leads to the strongest card professor, Richie Merced, to fight Keith. Yugi defends Keith and Gecko explains that he and Yugi are the targets, not Keith. After Gecko's defeat, Keith engages Richie, revealing his new ace card, the Wicked Eraser. You Bandit Keithians in the audience can rejoice, because this f***ing rando has effectively an Egyptian god card in the Yu-Gi-Oh! R manga. Upon defeating Richie, Keith takes Richie's special black duel disc, usurping the role as the strongest card professor. During the climax of Yu-Gi-Oh! R, Keith steps up against Yami Yugi and Gecko, but the potential duel is interrupted by Joey, who attacks Gecko mistakenly. After claiming that he used Yako to bring Joey here, Keith challenges Joey to a duel. Joey during this battle makes it a point to take cards from Keith to annoy him, using the time machine card that Keith left after their first match. Keith attempted to cheat like in Duelist Kingdom, however the black duel disc had an alarm that prevented him from using Ring of Destruction. Eventually, Keith summoned the Wicked Eraser, which was destroyed by Joey in the subsequent turn with Keith's own monster, Fiendish Engine Omega. Upon the Wicked God's defeat, Black Liquid attempted to absorb both Joey and Keith. The latter asked if Joey had felt this feeling before, as it was the feeling of death. Keith attempted to finish the duel, but Joey narrowly avoids defeat with Skull Dice. Keith begins breaking down as he explains that Joey is still alive, but Keith has already died. Joey pulls a biblically accurate angel and says, "Be not afraid," and summons Gearfried the Iron Knight, which destroys Keith's weakened monster and reduces his life points to zero. Joey reminisces about the Shadow Games with Young America in the semifinals of Battle City, and says that Keith's reaction shows that he is still alive. Keith throws the black duel disc at Joey, wanting a rematch, which Joey denies as he wants to duel him as a man, not some being of vengeance. Joey gives Time Machine back to Keith before running off and tells Keith to remember what it's like to duel for fun, and if he remembers that, he will face him anytime he wants. Now, as you notice, I did not editorialize that as much as usual, because frankly, I f***ing love Keith's role in Yu-Gi-Oh! R. While yes, it's merely rather fanfiction-y, giving a minor antagonist powers to rival the main characters, I am a massive villain resurrection enjoyer, and having a character like Keith return as a major antagonist in this manga is just awesome. Also, despite its dubious nature in the canon, if this is part of the story, it would serve as an excellent send-off to Joey's arc as well, as this will be the last duel he would have in the manga timeline, referencing Joey's growth throughout the story as someone who could barely play the game to one of the most competent characters in the series, who rematches his rival from the Duelist Kingdom arc. This duel also references his last duel in the Battle City arc by using Gearfried the Iron Knight, which famously fell just short of beating Young America in the series proper. Now, is Keith actually dead after the defeat of the Wicked Gods? Like many, many, many examples throughout this franchise, we don't know. I like the whole idea of the resurrection being a one and done, as Yako says that Keith's revival was a prototype for Pegasus' resurrection, which would assumably be permanent. Also, the language used by Joey after beating Keith assumes that he is still alive, However, with the final duel being immediately after this, and no epilogue to clarify the status of the Wicked Gods, Keith's stint in the story ends here. The story of Bandit Keith goes in two very different directions. In the anime, his defeat leaves him as a puppet to be controlled by Merrick, before being presumably killed or stealed by the Orichalcos. In the manga, he was confirmed to have died and revived after Battle City through Wicked God Voodoo magic. He's defeated by a Joey and left unconscious for the rest of the manga. So, do we have an overarching point? Revenge gets you nowhere? Bad life choices lead to bad life outcomes? Aiming a gun at a magic man leads to death? Probably one of those. Anyways, thank you for watching the Rise, Fall, and Rise Again of Bandit Keith. If you learned something new, press that like button, but don't unpress it. Press that subscribe button, but don't subscribe. And if this joke isn't hitting,
please.
Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.